ladies and gentlemen. It is my honor to welcome you to the annual commencement exercises of the Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology. Today, we have come to recognize the achievements of the 2023 graduating class of this esteemed institution. Their respective records of study have been verified, and each member has been duly admitted as candidates for the Associate of Science degree or the Bachelor of Science degree in their respective fields of study. As we begin the ceremony, please stand and help me welcome the distinguished graduates.
A pleasant good afternoon. Please stand as we invoke the presence of God here at today's ceremony. Bow with me. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless you. We magnify you. And we thank you, God, that we have come to a point of completion on our journey on the road to education. Now, Father, as we go forth in this grandiose ceremony, we ask that you be glorified, that your blessings be a saturating presence in this room, and above all else, may we find a greater level of joy and passion as we go on this new phase of life. In Jesus' name, and the people of God say, amen, amen and amen.
Lift up your head to the rising Bahama land. March on to glory, your bright banner waving high. See how your world Cabinet Ministers, Members of Parliament, President of Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology, Dr. Deslow Forbes, Chairman of the Board of Directors, Mr. Ricardo Smith, Guest Speaker, Mrs. Deborah Pratt, Ministry of Education officials, Assistant Commissioner of Police, Mr. B.K. Bonamy Jr., platform and specially invited guests, faculty and staff of BIBT, Freeport, and Nassau, ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2023, good afternoon. Today we are here to recognize the efforts and celebrate the achievements of this year's graduating class. Congratulations, class of 2023. You stayed the course. It is now time to celebrate. We acknowledge and thank the family and friends whose support made this day possible. We are delighted that you are here to share this occasion with us. We also take this opportunity to recognize our hardworking loyal staff and faculty of both Freeport and Nassau. And now I'll ask the staff and faculty of both Freeport and Nassau to stand so that we may recognize them. Ladies and gentlemen, even though Dr. Forbes has already welcomed you, I take this opportunity on his behalf, the faculty, staff, and the graduating class of 2023 to warmly welcome you to this afternoon's proceedings. Thank you for your presence, and I trust that you will enjoy this afternoon's ceremony. Good afternoon.
Inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer if you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside because you know you can survive. And when you feel like hope is gone, just look inside you and be strong. You finally see the truth that a hero lies. A long road when you face the world alone. No one reaches out a hand for you to hold. You can find love if you search into yourself, and the emptiness you feel will melt away. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on. You cast your fears aside because you know you can survive. And when you feel like hope is gone, just look inside you and be strong. You'll find that a hero lies in you. Who knows that dreams are hard to follow? So don't let anyone tear them away. In time you'll find.
running on the protocol that has already been established, I should like to bid everyone a good afternoon. Let me first say how elated I am to be here in Freeport with you today to celebrate this grand accomplishment of yet another BIBT graduating class. This afternoon is so much more special for us this year, as we, as a nation, are still in the celebratory mood of acknowledging our 50th year of independence. I pray God's blessing on this nation and on our institution as we continue to strive for excellence. The theme of this year's graduation is Vision for a Bright Future. As I pondered on your theme, I thought of the word vision. And from your theme, I got the understanding of vision meaning seeing. Seeing, dreaming, and making dreams and goals come to fruition. Our president and founder, Dr. Desmond Forbes, some 30 years ago, would have had a vision of establishing a college that would impact the Bahamas and make tertiary level education more accessible to the ordinary Bahamian. His vision was to make the future brighter for this nation. Today, countless persons have walked through the doors of BIBT, and indeed, as a result, their futures have been brighter. I can refer to so many people who would have attended this institution and have achieved a high level of success. But time today would not permit me to call each by name. With that said, graduates, the baton is now being passed to you. It is now your duty to take our communities and our country to the next level. Your vision should be clear, your goals well thought through, and you should have a strategy to make your future and the future of this country bright. You have the perfect example of visions for a bright future in the person of none other than our president, who embarked upon this journey more than 30 years ago. And today, as a result, our country and all of our futures are brighter. We are now your support kiosk. We are your resource center. But the task of using your vision to make your future bright rests squarely upon your shoulders. I say to you, go forth and change the world. You can do it. On behalf of the Board of Directors of BIBT, I wish to express our sincere confidence in you and in your ability to make this country a better place in which to live. On behalf of the board, we congratulate you on this major milestone today. We pray for you, we wish you Godspeed, and thank you all.
If I can help somebody as I travel along, then my living shall not be in vain. Mahalia Jackson. This is the philosophy that Deborah Pratt lives by. A certified corporate trainer, motivational speaker, life coach, writer. She is the president of DAPS, Developing Attitudes for Potential Success, Corporate Training and Business Services. A firm believer in the saying, your attitude determines your altitude. Deborah is passionate about motivating others to develop and maintain positive attitudes and realize their full potential in life. This is the core of her messages as a speaker and trainer, and the basis on which she wrote a weekly motivational column for the Freeport News for more than 10 years. As a corporate trainer, Deborah specializes in soft skills training. However, her passion is customer service training. Over the past 18 years, she has conducted seminars, workshops for hundreds of individuals of various companies and organizations. Beside her work with DAPS, she is an associate trainer with the Ministry of Tourism and facilities training sessions for other government departments, including the Ministry of Youth, Public Service Department, and the National Training Agency, where she also serves as a member of the Board of Directors. She is also a facilitator for the U.S. Embassy Academy for Women Entrepreneurs Program here in the Bahamas. A visionary life coach, Mistress Pratt enjoys helping women to discover purpose, pursue their passion, unleash their potential, and bring the vision for their lives to reality. Besides one-on-one coaching, she has also hosted several women empowerment events. She is a distinguished Toastmaster who takes much joy in using the public speaking skills she has learned to be a voice of empowerment to others. Deborah's community and civic affiliations include being a member of the Pilot Club of Lucaya, an ambassador with the Ministry of Tourism People to People program, and a leading lady in the Prentice Court Ministries, a membership program for girls. She is a member of New Horizon Worship Center, where she serves as a council member, Connect group leader, and the marriage ministry leader, along with her husband. Married to Mr. Dwayne Pratt, Deborah says, her greatest joy comes from being a wife for the past 31 years and a mother to their three gifts from God, Danielle, Destiny, and Dana. Graduates, please stand with me as we welcome our guest speaker.
You may be seated. President Dr. Jezebel T. Forbes and our esteemed platform guests, faculty and staff of Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology, ladies and gentlemen, class of the 2023, good afternoon. I am indeed honored to be your speaker this afternoon for this 2023 commencement ceremony under the theme, visions of a bright future. While my speech this afternoon is primarily geared towards our graduates, it is my hope that all of you here as supporters this afternoon will find some value in it. Graduates, I, and I am sure all of us here this afternoon, look at you and we see before us visions of a bright future. We look at you with much pride and hope, believing that you will all contribute to a bright future for Grand Bahama Island and the Bahamas at large. What about you? Can you visualize that bright future for yourself? I hope that each of you will take this theme personally and see a bright future for yourself. And as a graduating class, you will all have visions of a bright future. You have all made it to a pivotal milestone in your lives as you prepare to graduate with your respective degrees this afternoon. This accomplishment is another step towards that bright future. It is indeed a time to celebrate, but the celebration can only go on for so long before you continue working towards that bright future. The late Dawn Shula, former coach for the Miami Dolphins, had a 24-hour rule for his team. He allowed himself, his coaching staff, and his players a maximum of 24 hours to celebrate a victory or brood over a defeat. During those 24 hours, he encouraged them to feel their emotions of success or failure as deeply as they could. Well, this is not the end of a game for you, but instead the end of years of studies. So you may deserve a little more than 24 hours to celebrate. But my point is that you should not celebrate forever, but instead begin planning your next step towards that bright future now. So often we get caught up in celebrating our victories for so long, and it takes us back, it keeps us back from preparing for the next step. So what is next for you, graduates? I'm sure you're thinking, Mrs. Frank, we're just graduating this afternoon. We want to relax for a while and not think about what's next. But reality is, if you want to move forward to that bright future, you must begin planning now. For each of you, that bright future looks different. You have different dreams, different visions for your lives. While some of you are graduating with the same degrees, pursuing the same careers, etc., as individuals, you are all responsible for designing your own future. Close your eyes for a moment, graduates. Close your eyes for a moment, graduates. Imagine it is November 26th, 2033, 10 years from now. Where are you? What are you doing? Who are the people around you? What do you see? Now open your eyes. Were you excited about what you saw in your future? Great. Zig Ziglar said, if you can dream it or imagine or visualize it, then you can achieve it. None of us can say for certain that we will be here in another 10 years. But we should always plan for the future. You should all have a vision, a mental picture of where you want or what you want your life to look like in the future. And having that vision, you should document it so that you can follow it. Just as an architect draws a plan Troy building, and the contractor follows the plan to construct the building, you should have a plan for your life, for that bright future that you envision, so that you can create it. You are the architect and contractor of your life. In the book of Habakkuk, chapter 2 and verse 2, we are reminded to write the vision and make it clean. How many of you have been to a vision board party before? Any of you? Vision boards have become quite popular over the past few years. For those who may not have heard about it, a vision board is basically a poster board where someone would paste pictures from magazines or pictures that they download from their computer that depicts what they want from their lives or for their lives in the future. For example, they may have cars or their dream home or dream vacations or a fit, healthy body. Whatever it is that they want, they will have on that board. And some people will usually have inspirational quotes to go along with them. I brought with me this afternoon a vision board that I created 4 years ago on my 50th birthday. On my 50th birthday, I hosted a vision board party where I brought together a few ladies who were also turning 50 that year. And we drafted out exactly what we wanted our future to look like. Now, keep in mind, this was 4 years ago. So I have a picture of myself there saying 50 and fabulous. I have a picture of my family, because for me, family is everything. My family, my husband is here right now in the front here. Say hi, Mr. Dwayne Pratt. My family, my husband, and my daughters, they are my greatest supporters. So I have my family here because they are my greatest supporters. Other things I have on my board, debt-free zone. Not there yet, but hey, it's on my board and I'm working towards it, to be debt-free one day. I also have here to travel the world. This was 4 years ago, COVID came and interrupted that, but I've been at least one place that I had not been before then. I have here to become fit, become healthy and fit, and as you can see, I'm still working on that one. I don't know exactly why I thought to put this picture of these three skinny ladies. I don't know what I was thinking there, but I'm still working on becoming healthy and fit. I also have yet to publish that book. That's not been done yet, but it is in progress. I have here also to become a more sought-after speaker. It's my business in terms of my being a corporate trainer and speaker to be getting more doors opened to me. And I can say, within the last 4 years, I have definitely been realizing that. I'm here standing, speaking to you today. I also have some motivational quotes to remind me. I can do all things through Christ, for I know the plans that he has for me, or plans that you have for me, declares the Lord. Or I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. I have here something saying, don't be afraid of being different. Be afraid of being the same as everyone else. And I'll read that again. Don't be afraid of being different. Be afraid of being the same as everyone else. And small minds can't comprehend big spirits. To be great, you have to be willing to be mocked, hated, and understand. And misunderstood, but stay strong. So that's just to give you an example of a vision board. There are many persons who have said that vision boards have actually helped them to manifest their dreams. We have stars like Oprah Winfrey, Steve Harvey, just to name a few. Whether you choose to write your vision on a board or create write your vision in a journal or create your vision board. All I'm saying to you is to document it. You would find then when you actually write and document exactly what it is that you want to achieve, that will help you to get there. And in writing, you're not just writing it and putting it away. You're writing it and you're looking at it periodically. I look at my board periodically. I write a lot, so I have journals upon journals. You look at them periodically and you just tick off as you go. For example, if some of you now have vision boards, or you may have had your vision written in a journal, this accomplishment today, with you graduating with this degree, is something that you can probably just tick off and feel happy that you actually achieved it. Again, we cannot predict our future, but you can work on creating the future you desire. So how can you create that bright future? Allow me to use the word BRIGHT, B-R-I-G-H-T, as an acronym to talk to you this afternoon about what you would need to do in order to get to that bright future that you envision. B, bold. In order to get to that bright future that you envision, you will have to be bold. To be bold is to be courageous, not to be held back by fear. So often people have big dreams for their lives, but they allow fear of failure or opinions of others to hold them back. This is your life. If it's something that you want to achieve, go after it. Even if you fall or fail, learn from those lessons and try again. Queen Latifah said, be bold, be brave enough to be your true self. So often people try to be others, to do what everyone else is doing, instead of being their authentic self. I encourage you to be your authentic self and be bold in your pursuit of your bright future. Robert Kiyosaki said, often in the real world, it's not the smart that gets ahead, but the bold. So besides being bold, in order to get to this bright future that you envision, you must also be resilient. To be resilient means to rebound or to spring back. The bright future that you envision is not going to happen overnight. And let me repeat that. That bright future that you envision, those great dreams that you have, they are not going to happen overnight. Many obstacles will come in your way. You will fail and fall many times. But if it's something that you really want to achieve, you must be resilient. You must learn to bounce back. Some of you may have experienced this on your journey towards the degree that you are graduating with today. There may have been times that you wanted to give up, but each time you failed, you bounced back. Can anyone testify to that? There may have been times when you wanted to give up, but each time you failed, you bounced back. Aren't you glad you didn't give up? A few of you shook your head and you said yes, there were times when you wanted to give up, but aren't you glad? If you had given up, you may not have been seated where you are today. So give yourself a hand. Winston Churchill once said, success is not final. Failure, success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. The courage to get back up, to be resilient, to bounce back and continue, that is what counts. So you want to be bold, you want to be resilient, and you want to be innovative in order to get to that bright future. To be innovative is to think outside of the box, to innovate or introduce something new, or make changes to something that is already established. What is that career that you are embarking on, or maybe already in? Some of you may be entrepreneurs, while others may work in a profession or for a corporation. Some of you may have bright ideas of something that you want to create or invent. Never, I repeat, never be afraid to try something new or do things differently. Audrey Caballo says, be an innovator, not an imitator. G, besides being bold, resilient, innovative, you must also be goal-oriented. A goal is defined as the result or achievement toward which effort is directed, or something that you are aiming for. To be goal-oriented is to be focused on achieving a particular aim or result. To reach that bright future, you must be goal-oriented. You must have goals that you are striving for along the way. Tony Robbins said, "Setting goals is the first step in turning the invisible into visible." Or, I would say, setting goals is the first step in making those dreams or that vision a reality. To get to that bright future, there may be many goals you may have to achieve. I encourage you to write those down as well. You can categorize the goals in three categories. Short-term goals, those things that you may need to or want to work on achieving for the next, between the next 1 and 5 years. Medium-term goals, 5 to 10 years. Or long-term goals, anything more than 10 years. So, be goal-oriented. Set goals to get you to that bright future. And write them in those three categories. Short-term, medium-term, or long-term. So you want to be bold, you want to be resilient, innovative, you want to be goal-oriented. And for the H, you must be a hard worker. As I said earlier, the bright future will not just happen. You have to work hard to achieve it. Bruce Lee said, "Preparation for tomorrow is hard work today." Preparation for tomorrow is hard work today. So often we visualize these things that we want to achieve, but we don't want to put in the work to achieve it. Success comes before work only in the dictionary, says Vince Lombardi. Success comes before work only in the dictionary. So other than that, if you want success, you must work hard to achieve it. This is your vision. You can't depend on anyone else. No one will work as hard as you to achieve it. It may take a lot of blood, sweat, and tears, but if you want it bad enough, you must work hard to achieve it. And lastly, be, you want to be bold, R, resilient, I, innovative, G, goal-oriented, H, a hard worker, and T, you must be tenacious. To be tenacious is to hold fast to something, to be steadfast, persistent, strong-willed, unwavering, relentless in your pursuit to achieve those goals and your overall vision. It's as if you're saying to yourself, I am not going to stop. I am going to continue working at this until I achieve it. To succeed in life in today's world, you must have the will and tenacity to finish the job, says Chin Chu. The most difficult thing is the decision to act. The rest is merely tenacity, says Amelia Earhart. The most difficult thing is the decision to act. The rest is merely tenacity. When you made the decision to attend this college to get your degree, that may have been difficult for you. The most difficult thing is to get started. But once you get started, what keeps you going is tenacity. So it's because of your tenacity that you are sitting here preparing to graduate this afternoon. So graduates, I applaud and congratulate you all on making it to this point this afternoon. But I say to you again, don't celebrate too long. Continue working towards those visions for a brighter future by being bold, resilient, innovative, goal-oriented, a hard worker, and tenacious. I wish you all much success ahead. And I, as well as your supporters here, can't wait to see all that you will accomplish as you go on to your bright future. Forgive me for wearing my shades. I can't help it, because as I look at you, I see vision of a bright future. Thank you.
Dr. Forbes, in my capacity as Director of Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology, Freeport, I have carefully examined the academic records of our graduands and can confirm that each candidate has met the minimum requirements for the conferral of the Associate and Bachelor of Science degrees.
Thank you, Mr. Sherman. I'm reminded of Jesus and his disciples on the road to Emmaus, right? And they didn't know who Jesus was. Actually, this man was talking to them and didn't our hearts burn within us? And I say to you graduates, did not your heart burn and was filled after that speech from our esteemed guest speaker? I think she laid it out plainly for you, particularly in terms of the vision board. How many of you have the vision board? Not many, eh? But now it's a good time to maybe that's one of the things you should put on the vision board. Developing a vision board. So yeah, you can go ahead and do that. And make sure it's your own vision. I was reading a WhatsApp message earlier today from someone, and they were telling me about, the message was about a drunk guy who was traveling through the woods, and he came upon a preacher who was baptizing people for his church. I don't know, you might have heard this story before. And he saw the drunk guy and he grabbed him and said, "Boy, don't you want to be baptized?" And the drunk fellow said, "Yes, I want to be baptized." So the preacher took him and dipped him into the water, pulled him up and said, "Did you see Jesus?" Preacher said, the guy said, "No, I didn't see him." So he plunged him back in the water and pulled him up. Said, "Did you see Jesus?" The guy said, "No, I haven't seen him." So he plunged him back in the water again and pulled him up. Said, "Did you see Jesus?" He said, "No." So this time the preacher grabbed him, put him down in the water, and held him down there for a few seconds. Well, pulled him up. Say, "Did you see Jesus?" The drunk guy said, "Yeah, yes, I saw him." Say, let get me out of here, man. I saw Jesus. I said that because I want to illustrate to you that the guy might have seen a vision, of Jesus, but it wasn't his vision, It was the vision of the preacher who wanted him to see Jesus. So the thing about visions is you have to make the vision your own, It's got to be your vision, not somebody else's vision. The customary thing for parents to do is say, "Oh, I want my child to be this. I want my child to be that." And then they force the child into some program. And maybe the child makes it, or maybe he doesn't, or she doesn't. But the thing is, the vision of the parent is not necessarily the vision of the child, The child must have his own vision. And so what I'm saying to you, graduates, is that as you think about visions of a bright future, you've got to make it your vision, what you want to achieve, not what someone else wants you to achieve. And so with that said, let me get to the task at hand, which is to confer the bachelor's and the associate degree on those candidates who have been presented here today. And I will start with the associate degree students. As president of the Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology, it is my privilege to proclaim that all persons to whom these presents may come greeting acknowledge that on this 26th day of November, in the year of our Lord 2023, in consideration of the satisfactory completion of the prescribed curriculum of study, and upon the recommendation of the Academic Committee, I, having been duly entrusted, admit each member of this 2023 class to the Associate of Science degree, together with all rights, privileges, honors and immunities thereunto appertaining. As a symbol of this achievement, I now ask the candidates here present to position their tassels to the right and to don their academic hoods.
There you go.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the proud and distinguished 2023 Associate Degree graduates. And now, for those candidates receiving the Bachelor of Science degree, please step forward. As president of the Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology, it is my privilege to proclaim that all persons to whom these presents may come greeting acknowledge that on this 26th day of November, in the year of our Lord 2023, in consideration of the satisfactory completion of the prescribed curriculum of study, and upon the recommendation of the Academic Committee, I, having been duly entrusted, admit each member of this 2023 class to the Bachelor of Science degree, together with all rights, privileges, honors, and immunities thereunto appertaining. As a symbol of this achievement, I now ask the candidates here present to position their tassels to the right and present themselves to be hooded by the faculty. Ladies and gentlemen, your newest Bachelor of Science degree holders, give them a round of applause. He said, what a feeling, what a feeling. Doesn't it feel great now to have these degrees? No? Oh, yes. Now we have to make these degrees work for us, eh? We have to make them work for us. Please be seated. Join the others in congratulating you on reaching this very significant milestone in your academic lives. I wish you the very best as you work towards achieving your vision of a bright future. Let me offer special congratulations to Tanae Cooper. Certainly, to me, your stellar performance, your program of study is noteworthy and deserving of special recognition. I likewise also want to congratulate the top performers in the other disciplines. We know that those persons who burn the midnight oil sacrifice much to excel in their various programs of study. So I congratulate them as well. You will hear from them or hear their names later in the program. As I look around the auditorium, I see many friends and family, all of whom have come to support you graduates on this momentous occasion. No doubt you've had their support from the start of this journey to this very day, and I suppose they will continue to support you throughout your professional development career. Let's stand, graduate, and give them a big round of applause. I don't think their support can be overstated or underestimated. Certainly, for some of you, if you didn't have them, I don't think you'd make it here today. So we definitely have to show our appreciation to them. And while you're standing, let's recognize Mrs. Sherman and Ms. White and the hard-working staff of BIBP. They gave of themselves in every way that was possible to them to make sure that you made it to this day. So I know that many of you, once you leave the halls today, you won't look back. But it's always good. I think in the Bible, Jesus said, where are the nine? So let's make sure the nine comes back and show our appreciation to the staff and faculty of BIBT. Report. Thank you, Mary C. As you bask in this moment of ecstasy, I can't help but reflect on the many struggles you overcame to make it to this day. I do not wish to catalog each challenge that may have confronted you, but it's noteworthy that for the majority of you, this journey began during the COVID-19 pandemic. Many persons put everything on hold during this catastrophic period. But unlike them, you decided to invest in your education. Today, I think you would agree that the decision to use your time in this fashion is paying off handsomely. The pandemic was difficult, but instinctively you knew how to navigate the complexities of the situation so that at the end of the proverbial day, you would not be disadvantaged. You rose above the smothering tribulations of COVID-19 and emerged victorious. Ladies and gentlemen, that took courage, that took perseverance, and that took commitment, all qualities necessary for continued success as these graduates work towards their vision of a bright future. As the chairman said, this year we celebrated 50 years as an independent nation, a proud achievement for Bahamians throughout the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. Truly a salient statement of the work of our forefathers and the many others who continue to contribute to the building of this great nation. As members of this graduating class, the load is now on your shoulders. Your newly gained knowledge and the skills you acquired should be used to take these beautiful islands to new levels of prosperity and growth. Graduates, you are inheriting a world fraught with challenges and despair. Countries are at war. The earth is on fire from global warming. Religious hatred and racism abound. And in many places, people are without food and medicine. And as a new generation of Bahamians, the threat of artificial intelligence is worrying. Do not be overwhelmed by these calamities. You must continue to be courageous and apply your creative juices to resolving these problems and making your vision of a bright future more than just a figment of your imagination. You must persist at all costs and never give up, for it's only through faith in God, hard work, perseverance, and dedication that you will reap the benefits promised in your vision of the future. Thank you for making BIBT your college of choice. We cherish the time you spent with us, but most of all, we wish you every success as you enter this new phase of your lives. Embrace every opportunity to pursue your goals and achieve your vision. Congratulations.
Changing world where change is inevitable and all around us. It is essential that we graduates adapt to the necessary changes that can help us achieve successful and productive lives. Take a moment to envision the following: inclusive and progressive healthcare where medicine is accessible to everyone regardless of financial circumstances or nationality. Let's consider the high inflation of fuel. Just imagine the advancement of electric cars and portable charging stations eliminating the use of fuel. Education will incorporate diverse learning materials that cater to people of any ethnicity, race, learning disability, or nationality. Fellow classmates, the birth of these changes begins with us. We are the ones who will propel these visions to come true. And it all started the day we entered Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology. Dr. Deswell Forbes, distinguished guests, faculty and staff members, and my fellow graduates of the Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology, a pleasant good afternoon. There is an old African proverb that states, it takes a whole village to raise a child. This simply means that the raising of a child is a collective effort that requires the whole community to come together and invest in the child's upbringing. By nurturing and guiding the child in the right direction, the child will grow up to create a vision of what he or she would like to be in the future. On behalf of the class of 2023, I take this opportunity to express our sincere gratitude to the entire community that has nurtured and groomed us for this momentous occasion. You have inspired us and given us access to a bright future. To the staff and faculty of BIBT, I express my gratitude to you for imparting your knowledge and skills to equip us for today's society. You stimulated the birth of visionaries. The class of 2023 heralds a bright future. Although at times it seems like the workload never stopped with the countless videos, presentations, case studies, and endless Zoom meetings that started from 5 p.m. and lasted sometimes until 10 p.m., leaving our sleep schedules in total disarray. We now realize that you were preparing us for what was to come, and your efforts found fertile ground. You made us think about our short and long-term goals and helped us assess where we'd like to be in the future. Thank you for your hard work and dedication. To our friends and family, thank you for being our support system throughout this academic journey and encouraging us to keep going despite the stumbling blocks that came our way. I'm sure that my sentiments represent those of my fellow classmates by letting you know that you are truly appreciated. The personal tragedy of losing my brother last year made the journey even more challenging. And there were times when I felt like giving up. However, your words of encouragement and small gestures remind me that the race is not for the swift, but for those who endure until the end. You reminded me to write down my vision and make it clear. Who would have thought that the goal I wrote down in 2013 and kept in my Bible would come to fruition? But it did. This accomplishment is not only for me, but for my little brother, Ted Cooper Jr., who has the best seat in the house. May you continue to watch over me and rest in peace. Last but certainly not least, to the class of 2023, congratulations. Congratulations on completing our respective degree programs and being obedient to God during this season of life. By doing so, we have opened the door for God to use our lives to make history. As Nelson Mandela once said, education is the single most powerful weapon you can use to change the world. The world is ready for us to use every tool we have been equipped with during our time here at BIBT. It is time for us to join the village and make the changes that are necessary. Although we had little rest, we were surely stressed. We were tested and pushed to the limit. But here we are today. By God's grace, we made it. Let us continue to write many visions, etch our names in the growth and advancement of our society, then ensure that the future is always looking bright. Congratulations to us, and the best is surely yet to come as we envision a bright future.
Good evening, everyone. Dark is the night,
I can weather the storm. Where say that I've been down this road before. I never quit, never lay down. See, I promised myself I'll never let me down. So I never give up, never give in, never let a ray of doubt slip in. And if I fall, I never fail. I just get up and try again. Never lose hope, never lose faith. There's much too much at stake. One must be patient. I'm not looking for place. For sure, I'm gonna leave. No stopping now. There is still ways to go. Some way, somehow. Whatever it takes, I know. I'll never quit. No, no, no. I'll never go down. I'll make sure they remember my name 100 years from now. I'll never give up, I'll never give in, I'll never let a ray of doubt slip in. And if I fall, I'll never fail. I'll just get up and try again. Never lose hope, never lose faith. There's much too much at stake. Upon myself, I must depend. I'm not looking for place or show. I'm gonna win. When it's all said and done, my once in a lifetime will be back again. Now is the time I take a stand. Here's my chance that I never give up, never give in. Oh. And if I fall, I'll never fail. I'll just get up and try again. Never lose hope, never lose faith.
Merit, Associates of Science degree with highest honors, Accounting Management. Roy McLean. Accounting Management with Distinction. Aaliyah Grohl. Accounting Management with Highest Honor. Tika Saunders, Accounting Management with Highest Honor. Felicia Roma, Banking and Finance with Distinction. Verlicia Scott, Banking and Finance with Honors. Nico Jones, Business Administration. Kenneth Miller, Business Administration with Distinction. Oliver Hines, Business Administration with Distinction. Zenitrick Watson, Computer Network Technology, Highest Honors. Lakasha Cooper, Early Childhood Education with Honors. Antoinette Cox Lewis, Early Childhood Education with Honors. Renee Davis. Yay! Early Childhood Education with Honors. Felicia Forbes. Early Childhood Education with Honors. Early Childhood Education with Honors. Jeronique Russell, Early Childhood Education with Distinction. Keisha Russell, Early Childhood Education with Honor. Tiffany Ballou, Human Resource Management with Honor. Charlene Ramey, Medical Assisting with Honors. Sonia V. Rule. Medical Office Administration with Honors. Luzma. Paralegal Studies with Honors. Razik Comer, Pharmacy Technician. Early Childhood Education,
summa cum laude. Renasia Burrows, Healthcare Administration. Danica Thompson, Human Resource Management. Education cum laude. Siobhan Mahesh Samelfort, Primary Education, magna cum laude. And presentations. So the following presentations are made to the highest achievers in each discipline. I will again begin with those who have earned their associate's degrees. Pharmacy technician, Jaden Bartlett. Pharmacy technician, Brazik Colmer. Administration, Sonia V. Roll. Medical Assisting, Charlene Rami. Human Resources, Tiffany Ballou. Yes,
Childhood Education, Lakasha Cooper. Early Childhood Education, Lakeisha Russell. Early Childhood Education, Derenique Russell. Computer Network Technology, Zenitric Watson.
That's my brother!
Business Administration, Zeniko Jones. Business Administration, Erica Oliver Hines. Business Administration, Kenneth Miller. And Finance, Berlicia Scott. Banking and Finance, Berlicia Roma. Accounting Management, Aaliyah Rowe. Accounting Management, Leroy McLean. Accounting Management, Jaquel McIntosh. Latoya Major Rowe. Business Administration, Chelsea Rowe. Business Administration, Phantom Pratt. Yeah. Talent Education, Tanae Cooper. Healthcare Administration, Renasia Burrows. Human Resource Management, Danica Thompson. Primary Education, Laura Martin. Javon Nottage Samelford Primary Education. And final award for the disciplines, Primary Education, Agnes Sands Cumberbatch. Institute of Business and Technology, Freeport, salutes Agnes Sands Cumberbatch for excellent academic and salutatorian commencement 2023. Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology, Freeport, salutes Tanae Cooper for exemplary academic achievement as valedictorian commencement 2024.
Guessing already who that is. tell you now that the person who is receiving this award is Mr. Kenneth Miller.
Mistress Pratt, the 2023 graduating class of Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology appreciates that you took the time to spend this afternoon with us. We assure you that your words of wisdom will not go on deaf ears. So please accept this plaque as our thanks for serving as our distinguished guest speaker for the 20th commencement ceremony of Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology.
Right, right about here, everybody who has a horn, a cowbell, a whistle, let me hear that. Graduates, please stand. Raise your right hand for me, please. And repeat after me. I hereby pledge my unwavering support, loyalty, dedication, and commitment to BIBT's Alumni Association. I promise to be faithful and available and call upon to assist the association. So help me God. You are all the newest members of the Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology Alumni Association.
I begin with a borrowed statement that gratitude is the most exquisite form of courtesy. So in that vein, I thank all present here for a wonderful evening. A special thanks to the president and visiting colleagues from our Nassau campus, to our administrators at the Grand Bahama office, immense thanks. I cannot forget our dedicated and committed professors. Thank you also. Thanks to our guest speaker, Mrs. Pratt, who so ably encouraged, stimulated our graduates to think and plan. From the reaction to your message, Mrs. Pratt, it found fertile ground. To all participants, you made the flow of the ceremony seamless. Thank you. thanks to the administration of the Bishop Michael Eldon School for the use of the hall. To you, parents, spouses, and other family members of our graduates, thank you. Lastly, graduates, thanks to you, for you made this ceremony possible. Thanks again, and enjoy the rest of a beautiful evening.
In the vein of celebration, let us stand all over the building as we seek God's blessing one more time. Bow with me in a word of prayer. Father, you have shown your blessing and grace upon us today. And as the ceremony has come to its conclusion, may your wind be at our back and lead us and guide us into divine opportunities. Father, we decree and declare in this atmosphere that no door that you have ordained shall be blocked or hindered from our graduating class. Father, on their jobs, in their businesses, in their homes, may Deuteronomy 28 be their portion always. And Father, as we leave this place and surely not your presence, may you continue to be glorified as we set our sights on a bright future. In Jesus' name, and the people of God say,
amen,
amen and amen.